Once I walk up there, it'll be fine. But right now. Right now, the head is hurt.
Thank you. Friday night with us. This is the Providence College Jazz Ensemble. Give them another round of applause. That's a great jazz standard by the tenor saxophonist Sonny Rollins, who is still with us. He retired from playing a few years ago. I think he's in his 80s, almost 90 now. One of the last great jazz masters that's with us, called Doxy, and that featured James D. Donato on tenor sax. I think I have the order right. Ava Navarro on Barry sax. Brian Dubowick on trombone. And Evan Smith on alto saxophone. This next selection is one of my favorite jazz ballads. It's by one of the great jazz composers, certainly the second part of the 20th century, named Thad Jones. He plays trumpet player and played with Count Basie, among a number of other bands, and was part of that great rebirth of the Basie band in the 50s when they were backing up great singers like Frank Sinatra. Thad Jones was a member of that band and then went on to have a great career as a band leader of the cleverly named Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra. Mel Lewis was the drummer in that band. But he wrote this beautiful ballad, A Child Is Born, and it's going to feature our pianist, Greg Semeca, and Austin Whitaker on flugelhorn. Thank you. James B. Donato on tenor. Ryan Pizzuto on guitar. And Evan Smith on alto saxophone. We've got a lot of great famous jazz songwriters on this set, and the next selection is a tune called Filthy McNasty, which is a blues by one of the great hard bop piano players and band leaders, Horace Silver. So this is going to feature a whole bunch of us on this great blues tune, Filthy McNasty. Thank you. things up a little bit. This is a song that was made famous on the pop charts back when I think I was in college, when it came out back in the 90s, late 90s. And Norah Jones didn't write it, but she made it famous. And we've got a lot of great talent in the PC Music Department. We're going to feature one of our graduating seniors who is graduating in with degrees in musical theater and music technology and production. Good. And this is, please welcome to the stage, Claire Krug.
Thank you.
hand for Claire. If you saw some juggling of instruments back there, the previous tune, Don't Know Why, also featured our bassist, who's really a guitarist. How about a round of applause for Evan Starr? Really nice solo back there, Evan. He's back on bass guitar now. We're going to continue our set with a tune that was written by the great Herbie Hancock. But he wrote it in the early 60s, and he didn't actually have the most famous version originally. It came out about 10 years later with his famous version with the group The Headhunters. But the person who really kind of put this tune on the scene wasn't Herbie. It was a Cuban conga player named Mongo Santa Maria. And some of the students took my jazz history course, I think, and they really wanted to play this tune. So this is Watermelon Man by Herbie Hancock, but sort of the Mongo Santa Maria version. So hope you like it. Claire's not the only one who can sing, clearly. Next selection is Flight of the Foobirds. This is off one of those great Count Basie albums from the mid-1950s. I mentioned Thad Jones earlier. If you look up that album, if you're looking to build a record collection, that's a great place to start. The Atomic Count Basie is a great album. And this is right off that, and Thad Jones takes a solo on that, and it's going to feature one of our seniors, Austin Whitaker. Who else will it feature? Ryan Peduto and Evan Smith on alto saxophone. Flight of the Foobirds by Neil Hefti. But the other side of that is you get to know them pretty well, and then they leave. And that's kind of hard. I was meeting with some colleagues, and I have the great benefit, along with my other colleagues in the music department. Most of the professors at PC don't have the benefit of having students repeatedly, semester after semester. And so you get very attached to some of these students. We're going to miss three of our seniors who came in the dark times, right in the heart of COVID, and they've been absolute stalwarts and grown musically and as people. It's really been a privilege. I just want to recognize them and wish them well and have you recognize them. Ava Navarro on baritone sax. private lessons almost all 4 years, just about, completed a music minor. Yeah, completing it after the semester. We'll be completing it. We wish her very well. Austin Whitaker on trumpet. Austin is one of our rare people who actually just keeps taking on more and more music. He came in and he's like, well, I'll play in Symphonic Winds, which is our concert band, concert next Sunday, not this Sunday, but next Sunday at the Smith Center. So he'll be playing in there. And then he obviously plays in the jazz ensemble. I think he only missed like one semester of both of those groups for a course conflict. And then he's played in pep band, which of course they play at all the men's and women's basketball games, plus men's and women's ice hockey. I think he missed one rehearsal this semester and he was all apologies. And I honestly can't remember another time he missed over 4 years. So Austin Whitaker, we're gonna miss him. Our guitarists, who's actually playing drums tonight, Griffin May, came in, and I think his first love is electric guitar, but he just loves all music, added a music minor, and has been studying music technology and production, and has really grown into a really fine jazz drummer. We wish him all the best. Griffin May on drums. After we came out tonight, we're going to close our set with a classic funk tune called The Chicken. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.